Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who don't know me, I am Zuhair, a UFT admit currently in my gap year. In this video, I am going to share all of the things that will help you get admission into Canada's number one university, University of Toronto. If you haven't watched my previous video in which I talked about how I got into University of Toronto, my application, stats, extracurriculars, and some of the things that helped me stand out, I recommend you watch that video before watching this one. Now, without further ado, let's get started. Number one, know the exact application process and the deadlines for both the main application and the supplementary application. Let me give you a brief overview of the application process at UFT. Because when I was applying as an international student, it took a lot of time to understand the exact process and the time interval between each step in the application process. The first thing to know is that you do not apply to UFT directly, but through a university application portal called the Ontario Universities Application Center, or OUAC for short. No matter whether you are a local, Canadian, or international student, the first step is to create an OUAC account and fill out all the required information in the application. The second step is to pay the application processing fee and submit your application to one or more programs and campuses of your choice. After you have submitted your application, in 1 to 2 weeks time, you can expect an email from UFT providing you with the login instructions, your application number, and the details on the next steps in the application process. Once you are able to access the Join UFT portal, you can check the status of your applications as well as the list of any required documents, including supplementary application. Though most programs do not require supplementary application, if your program does, you can access the detailed instructions and the application itself through your Join UFT portal. Now, the next step is to self-report your grade 11th and 12th grades and submit your transcripts on the Join UFT portal. And that's it, you are done. Also, next week, I'll be publishing a video on UFT's application process and will go over all the necessary steps in detail and step by step. So do subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get notified once I upload that video. What I suggest you to do is to schedule your deadlines for your main application and the supplementary applications in Google Calendar and set reminders weeks before the deadline to avoid last minute hassle. Even though this is a generic thing to keep in mind, I wanted to emphasize this because when I was applying to universities, I didn't know the power of calendar apps like Google Calendar or Microsoft Outlook Calendar to help you remember things in high school. And so I'm guessing that some of you might not know this and greatly benefit from calendar apps. Moving on to number two, do your research early on and know the admission requirements. Before wanting to get into University of Toronto, you need to figure out which programs you'd like to get into and what are their requirements. Each program is offered at a different UFT campus and has different subject and grade requirements. Generally, the minimum required percentage to get into UFT is low to mid 80s. But it can vary from program to program. Therefore, I suggest you to aim in the 90s to be on the safer side. Be sure to check the high school courses and subjects you need for your area of study and for the specific programs at the university. For example, mathematics and physics are pretty much the required subjects for most engineering majors, including computer science. And if you are doing the IB diploma program, you are absolutely required to have IB math, IB physics, IB chemistry, and IB English for admission into any engineering major at UFT. To find out the required subjects and their minimum scores needed to secure an offer, head over to University of Toronto's website, go to the academics section, click on the undergraduate programs. Now search for the program of your interest. After opening it, you will see the program details such as the campus at which the program is offered and the minimum academic requirements for most of the education systems. If you are an IB student, click on the International Baccalaureate link and you will see the minimum admission requirement, which is to have English HL or SL and to get the IB diploma. Now for the specific IB requirements, go to the expanded admission requirements by target faculty and choose the faculty offering the program and you will see the required subjects and their minimum scores. If English is not your first language, you are required to provide evidence of your English language proficiency, for which you have to take an English language proficiency test like the IELTS, the TOEFL or the Duolingo test and submit its official scores to the university. Also, there is a huge advantage if you are doing the IB program, because your English language requirement will be met if you scored a 4 or more in English A language and literature, either on HL or SL level. But you'll only know this if you have done your research and know the requirements. I remember one friend of mine who wasn't aware that most Canadian universities accept IB English A language and literature as a proof of English language proficiency and took the IELTS exam. Luckily, his IELTS test didn't go to waste because it is also required in the student visa application. Therefore, doing your research, knowing the requirements, choosing the right subjects, and scoring high in them can greatly boost your admission chances at UFT. Moreover, doing your research will not only help you keep track of the application process, but will also help you figure out whether UFT is the right place for you or not. Furthermore, it will give you a sense of clarity and purpose as you write your answers for the supplementary application, such as why you chose UFT or why you are interested in a particular program, etc. Moving on to number 3, which is to prioritize your academics over everything else. University of Toronto, like most Canadian and UK universities, is academically focused and largely considers your academic performance to be the deciding factor for admission. One of the reasons why I think this is the case is due to the fact that UFT gives out conditional offers which require you to maintain your grades. In my UFT offer, the academic condition was as follows: obtain the International Baccalaureate Diploma and maintain your current academic standing, particularly in any courses required for your intended program of study. Though universities around the world expect students to maintain their grades in their final exams, universities like UFT explicitly convey it in their conditional offers. If you haven't watched my college decisions reaction video, you might not know that I got rejected from every single university I applied to except UFT. Let me give you a little bit more context. So I applied to MIT, Stanford, Amherst, NYU, and all the other Ivy League schools, which look at students holistically by considering their personal qualities, their extracurriculars, leadership, their community involvement alongside their academics. For University of Toronto, I wasn't asked to write about my extracurriculars or share my personal qualities. They just asked for the transcripts. So you can see that the difference is apparent. But this is not to say that University of Toronto does not value a student's character, personal qualities, or extracurriculars, but that they prioritize and give more importance to your academic performance, i.e. your semester grades, your predicted scores, and your final exam scores. Therefore, regardless of the education system you follow, IB, AP, CBSE, A-levels, focus on getting exam results in the 90s. But do make sure that you are doing some impactful extracurriculars in your field to be on a safer side. Then you're good to go. Now moving on to number 4, which is to apply early. You actually increase your chances of admission by applying early, as UFT starts evaluating applications early on. Spots for the class will start filling as soon as UFT starts accepting applications, and you do not want to apply with a very good application when spaces have already filled up. On UFT's website, you'll find it clearly written that spaces fill quickly and programs may close before the application deadline is listed. Moreover, if you submit your OUAC application for a UFT's program which has closed, your application will be cancelled without a refund. Therefore, I'd encourage you to submit your application well in advance to be assured a spot at UFT. And this is actually true for almost all universities in general. Moving on to number 5, do not become complacent with regards to supplementary application. Even though grades are really important, they are not everything. You need to utilize every single opportunity to show your demonstrated interest. The supplementary application varies a lot depending on the program of your choice, but generally it asks you to state and describe the extracurricular activities that shaped you and developed skills that will help you succeed in the program you applied to. Here, I'll suggest you to focus on a few extracurriculars that had an impact on you. It can be leadership positions, clubs, MUN, student council, volunteering, and how the skills you develop can translate into your studies at UFT. For example, participating in MUN taught me to listen to others, often those with counter arguments, value their perspective, and reach to a common ground. The computer science or XYZ program involves a lot of group projects, and my experience as an MUN delegate will help me lead them while making sure that I heed to every single member's viewpoint to reach at pragmatic solutions. In the case of an online interview, it is really important that you do all the practice questions in advance, because one, you'll feel prepared and not stressed out, and two, the actual interview questions are very similar to the practice questions. Lastly, a big difference between the video interview and the supplementary application is that the video interview is timed, whereas the supplementary application isn't. So take your time, re-edit and get feedback for the supplementary application essays while also practicing for online interview questions. That's it for today, guys. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, please give it a like, because this will help more people as it will push this video to more people who need it. Also, if you'd like to get notified once I upload a new video, make sure you subscribe the channel and hit the bell notification icon. See you in the next video. Goodbye and take care.